and welcome to my channel. Today I have a makeup tutorial for you, obviously. And this time I just really felt like doing something different, something edgy, something glam and glittery, because I feel like it's been ages since I last used actual loose glitter on my eyeballs. Well, eyelids, technically. I don't know, I really wanted to use glitter. I know I'm going to regret it afterwards in the evening when I'm going to wash this off and will not be able to get the glitter off again, ever. But we'll just deal with that when we get there. Either way, I did want to combine it with something warm in terms of color, because cool shades just don't look right on me. And I feel like green on its own would have been too cool for my natural colors. It's less awful on me than blue, but still. So I did combine it with warm shades. So yeah, without further ado, let's get started. For the primer face, and I'm going to start on my eyelids. This way the primer on my face can just really sink into the skin while I do my eyeballs. And yeah, first off, I'm just applying a little bit of translucent powder on my eyelids, because I have oily skin and this is just going to help the primer to actually stay intact all day long. Also, by the way, I haven't done my eyebrows and eyelashes yet. I did tint them yesterday, so they're already dark. For the next part, other than eyeshadows, you'll also need something like this. Something like an old post-it note. This is actually an old list of how I used to do my setup. I never throw anything away. Point is, you can also use a business card, a shopping list, or a piece of tape. I personally don't like sticking things to my face, so I won't. But yeah, I just put this against my eye so I can just get a nice, clean, crisp edge to it. But we're still going to do concealer and foundation later on, so I'm just going to do the first crease shade, the transition shade, without the paper, so I don't need to hold it for longer than absolutely necessary. Okay, what I'm just doing now is applying the orange eyeshadow very thickly. The orange eyeshadow, I am applying orange eyeshadow now. I'm aiming it like along with the lower lash line, not necessarily to my eyebrow, but just with that lower lash line. And what I always do is just pack it on and then blend it out later without having to hold the piece of paper for 5 million years. When it's on there, I'm moving on to a red shade and just applying it pretty much the same way. Once you take it off, you'll see that it's not completely straight yet. You know, your skin is just not straight, and it always happens to me, obviously. So I'm just going to fix it with an eyeliner brush, but you already have that guidance there now. And then I'm just going to blend it further. I'm just going to do the eyebrow highlight real quick. I'm just going to use an off-white shade for that. And then heaps of blending. By the way, don't worry too much about the eyelids, because, we're just going to still do that later on. So it doesn't need to be neat at this point. And for the lower lid, I'm just going to use this brush, my beloved brush that I always used to use for this and then stopped using for some reason. Dark shade on the small end in the outer corner, and I'm blending it out with the bigger one and the orange shade. In case anyone's wondering what I'm wiping my brushes off on off screen, it's actually my office chair. I do recommend using a towel, I'm just too lazy to grab one. But anyway, now that it's on there, I'm just going to copy this to this eye and then I'll get back to you. Of course, you're going to notice you're going to have the first eye has to be darker. What can also work with blending really well is just applying heaps of eyebrow highlight, so you have actually a pale shade to blend with. Also, one trick with blending is have patience. Even if you think it's not going anywhere, just keep making this movement. Go watch a movie in the meantime and eventually it will work out. Most of the time. Eyeliner over glitter is usually not a good idea, because it will inevitably get all bumpy. So what I'm going to try to do is do my eyeliner first, then do the glitter, and then attempt to tidy up the eyeliner afterwards. By the way, fun fact, like, it's only now starting to become really autumn and cold in the Netherlands, so it's almost winter and only now do I actually have the feeling that it's autumn. I always feel like I'm, I don't know, slower with the seasons than the actual seasons, somehow. I went for a subtle eyeliner, but is anyone actually surprised it turned out this way? Anyhow, let's forget about that and just move on to the glitter. I'm going to use dark green and pale green glitter, and I'm going to use the NYX Glitter Primer as a primer. I'm using a different glitter than I originally planned because I can't get this tube to open. Oh, and a fair warning, glitter is forever. So do keep in mind that if you do this as well, you are going to find glitter for the next week in your hair, your clothes, your pores, your mouth, your room, your bathroom, just everywhere. Another tip, if you really want to be safe, of course, always whatever glitter you use, make sure it doesn't get in your eyeballs. But yeah, if you want to be safe, do use cosmetic glitter that's actually meant to be used on the eyes. Okay, I'm now going to attempt to get most of the glitter off my cheeks. Then I'm probably going to have breakfast and then I'll get back to you to finish up the eyes and the rest of the makeup. Okay, we're back onto eyelashes. I'm going to use quite a fluffy bigger pair because I do want to hide a little bit of the eyeliner. Of course, you can use mascara beforehand. Like I said at the beginning, I think I did. Anyway, I tinted my eyelashes, so they're already black, so I'm just going to skip this step. Then onto the eye pencil, which I need to sharpen first. My lower waterlines are going to be black. I'm also smushing it a bit below the lashes on the outer corners. Okay, then onto the steps, foundation and concealer. Of course, I was already wearing primer, so I'm just going to move on to those second two. For the part near the wings, I'm going to be a bit more careful and just use a brush first and then blend it out with the Beauty Blender. Powder. I'm also applying that with the Beauty Blender today. I'm not really gonna bake, I'm just literally applying the powder all over. And just going over it with a brush to make sure everything is nicely blended. Small update, other than having glitter everywhere, I also now have powder everywhere. It's going well here. Just blending my own lashes together with the falsies. I always try to do this after powder, because otherwise I'm just going to end up covering my eyelashes and mascara with powder anyway. On the lower lashes, I'm using a mascara that makes the lashes quite spiky, just so they match with the top side. Then the eyebrows, I'm going to save Oliver some time by just sort of skipping through that. And yeah, I'm just going to basically fill them in and then come back to do the rest of my face. Shaping, I'm going to do very mildly with rather a warm shade, just because I feel like it fits the look nicely. Okay, that really antique peachy blush that I used last time I'm going to use again. Because I certainly remembered why it used to be my favorite, because it just fits with absolutely anything. Then some setting spray. Now while the setting spray is still wet, I'm going to use the highlighter. You could go for something subtle. I went for glitter because, you know, why not? And this glitter actually stays on the face and you won't find back everywhere for the rest of your life. By the way, this is the highlighter that I showed a little while back in an empties video / one shopping haul thing. Yep. Anyway, it's a hypothermia from the Jeffree Star Cosmetics Supreme Frost. Really pretty and glittery. And then lastly, the lips. I'm doing those dark red. I had one issue with the highlight, that when I looked away, it gives a bit of a dark blur, but now that I blend it out even more, it just blends to my skin nicely. And that leaves us with the final results. Yeah, I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want, you can also subscribe to my channel. I do a lot of makeup tutorials and all sorts of other stuff. Also, I gotta admit, this particular look, I do like how it turned out, but especially with the eyeliner, I really had my doubts at some points if it was actually ever going to be a decent look. So yeah, it just goes to show, whenever you feel like something is a giant disaster, just keep going and it might actually turn out fine. If you're lucky. I was lucky today. Yeah, below this video, by the way, as always, you can find a full list of all the products I used. And again, as always, if you don't have the same products, doesn't matter, just use what you have. Like, I used a red liquid lip and you can use whatever red liquid lip you have. Doesn't matter, just go with what you like. Also, you can find all my social media accounts names below there, other than YouTube. I'm mostly active on Instagram. I share a lot of makeup there as well, just, you know, eye looks, mini tutorials, stuff like that. But also, I will share it there whenever I upload a new video onto my channel. So I would really love it if you'd want to follow me there. And yeah, that was it for today. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!